Welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. Sponsored by SawStop, North America's number one cabinet saw. For more information, visit sawstop.com. By Highland Woodworking, fine tools delivered to your door since 1978. Visit their website at highlandwoodworking.com. By Lee Valley and Veritas, with over 5,000 high-quality woodworking hand tools, visit their online catalog at leevalley.com. And by Centipede Tool, a revolution in sawhorse evolution. Visit their website at centipedetool.com. Hey everybody, welcome back to Matt's Basement Workshop. We have a super simple show here today talking about our super simple boxes. We had an audience member wrote in a question and we're concerned about the possibility that these miter joints at the end could possibly be opened up due to the fact that we glued in this bottom panel. And this is a really valid question and I'm kind of glad they asked it because I was wondering how many people might be concerned about this and maybe not even mention it, because I know as a beginning woodworker, I really never thought about expansion and contraction of the materials I was working with. So the first part of the answer for this particular audience member is, one thing I am not concerned about with this bottom panel here is, because I live in Michigan, I know I have four very distinct seasons. And with those four very distinct seasons, it really takes a, I don't want to say toll, but a toll to some degree on projects. And it's not just projects that I build, but it's also just the house in general, any type of wood component that we have in the house. And what ends up happening is in the summer months, there's that expansion due to the increase in temperature and humidity. And then in the winter, there is a contraction due to the drop in the temperature, but the humidity stays kind of relatively the same. So what I always do is I always build in just a little bit of expansion room in my projects, regardless of what they are. And this one was no different. So since expansion contraction occurs across the face of a board, it goes, here's the grain going parallel, it would go across this way. On either side of these, most situations with all the boxes, I left just a little bit of wiggle room. And since these are being built in the summer, this is when the wood is at its pretty much its biggest expansion point. So if anything, it's gonna contract, and these expansion areas here on the sides will kind of get a little bit bigger, but at the same time, it's not going to really affect the box at all. And I should mention too that in modern days, in our modern homes, since we have a lot more environmental control, we don't really think too much about the expansion and contraction issue, but it doesn't hurt to kind of build these things in just a little bit. Now, another thing I'm going to mention is the stock that I'm working with is definitely seasoned. This is material that has been dried properly, because I know the mill that I was getting this from. And when this stock came in, and I've had this particular Eastern White Pine for easily well over a decade now. It came over with us when we moved to the new house. This stuff came in probably about 8-9% humidity. And just to be on the safe side, I took my moisture meter before recording this video. I took some of the material, I checked it, and it's still somewhere around that range. In fact, it came in like give or take at 9%, so give or take 1 or 2 degrees or a percent of humidity. So it's staying very, very stable. Another tool that I would normally use is I kind of keep track of humidity and the temperature using just this simple gauge. I picked this up for like a buck or two at a local home center. I have one in the shop, I have one somewhere else outside, and I think I even have a third one somewhere in the house itself to help me kind of gauge what things are doing, just in case I don't trust this or I want to get a better feel for it. And also, if I want to think about like what the wood movement is going to do, here on my smartphone, you can find these online also if you don't have a smartphone, if you just want to look it up on your computer. But in this situation, I'm using the wood shop widget, and you can actually punch in the known humidity percentage that you have, start, and then you can also put in like what's going to happen if it goes up 1 or 2 degrees. And you can also put in like what the current humidity is using, say, a gauge like this with the temperature. And again, you can kind of gauge what it's going to do. And on top of it, it also will show you like what kind of material you're working with. Is it flat sawn? Is it radial? Is it quarter? And it will read out, you know, what the percentage or what the amount of movement you're going to get from it. So you can plan for these things. So it's important to have tools like this. And like I said, this is the smartphone version. You can also easily find something like that online without any problem at all. Just look, you know, for wood movement gauge or something, any type of basic search. So again, the two things so far that I took into consideration was I left those expansion marks or those expansion room on either side. I also am working with very seasoned, stable material. And the third thing that I'll always point out, and I've talked with experts about this, I have talked with a number of people who are seasoned woodworkers, and from my own experience also, the material I'm working with is about a quarter of an inch, 5/16 of an inch. And at this thickness, really, again, this is one more notch in the belt of chances are it's probably not going to move very much. It's very, very minimal. So that was one thing that helped me feel very reassured that these miters are not going to open. So with that said, hopefully that answered your question. Hopefully for some of you who are thinking the same thing, or maybe weren't even thinking about it at all, but now we're thinking about it, hopefully that kind of answered your question. You know, when it comes down to it, wood movement is something you really do need to think about with any of your projects, because it's something that can really take something that looks amazing and turn it into something that's like, well, we could burn it. That would always be fun, maybe for a nice campfire or something. But anyways, though, thanks again for sending in that question. And if you have comments, questions, suggestions, you know how to get a hold of me, mattsbasementworkshop@gmail.com. You can leave a comment in today's show notes over at mattsbasementworkshop.com. Or if you're watching this at YouTube, hey, leave a comment over there. I love hearing from all of you. So until the next episode, I'll be talking to you soon. Straight grains and sharp blades.
Thanks for watching. To find even more videos and woodworking related content, be sure to visit our website at mattsbasementworkshop.com. You can also find us on Facebook, Twitter, and Google+. And don't forget to subscribe to the show either on YouTube, in iTunes, or you can even receive email notifications whenever we post something new.